emerald for insight. Ruby for vigor. Opal for harmony.
Where'd Swain go? Yeah. Answers that question. With clarity. And went to finish this thriller.
Are you 100% going to PAX?
I can't say that for sure if you want the money before March 3rd. Oh, wait a second.
Ooh. Maybe you can, like, take a loan from your parents.
Oh. I didn't quite realize. That might be the weekend of States. Wrestling.
Huh.
I just realized March 6th.
Emerald for insight.
I need to play Tark more often. He's really strong.
Hello. Ah, it's better. Apparently my computer restarted, I don't know.
Interesting. Oh, wait, I should probably do some vision control. Sapphire. Forgot that.
I told you what would happen.
Deadly.
What happened?
Huh?
Are you winning?
Yeah. Good job. Jonathan Flash, though. Kinda forgot that. It's Tarik. Flash doesn't really change much.
Matt.
Huh? Oh, accident.
Jacob may not be able to go to PAX.
Okay.
And I still need to buy tickets, and I can only buy like, two at a time.
Uh-huh.
Through the place I'm buying it, so we could buy together.
Okay.
It's $270 though.
I have to ask my mom.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. I guess I could do that right now.
I mean, I can't right now.
I know, but I should probably ask her.
Yeah.
Oops.
Sadly, I think we might have to cancel out. In fact, I just realized what weekend that is.
I thought it was gonna be like in the middle of a week, or like Saturday, Sunday, and Monday, which would have been not good. But yeah, when it's Friday, I only have to miss high school and seminar, which isn't a big deal. If I had to miss a college class, I would say no. But I don't know, I have to ask.
Okay, I'm gonna ask Tyler right now if he can find time off for it.
I searched, should I go to PAX, just to see what would come up, and this is what came up.
Yeah, that is the same weekend, I'm sorry guys. That's March 5th through 7th, the states. So.
Five reasons not to go to PAX East. It's organized by people who make Penny Arcade. PAX East is run by a company behind the webcomic. Behind the webcomic, Penny Arcade. Penny Arcade is a bad comic that has inordinate influence among the sort of people who self-identify as gamers.
That's honestly just a good reason. I don't think I can go to PAX anymore.
Last year, Penny Arcade put up a job listing for an IT position. This basically said that the right candidate would be someone who doesn't mind working overtime with multiple IT positions. When you support PAX, you support a bad comp that has traded on its undue influence to underpay prospective employees. So this first reason is not really good. I'm still thinking going to PAX is a good idea after that one. Let's check reason two. Despite PAX trumpeting its attitude of inclusivity, at least one of the comic's creators doesn't seem particularly good at understanding or empathizing with others.
These reasons are too personal.
He made a rape joke. Alright, three. It's a giant mess. It's a giant commercial masquerading as a company. PAX bills itself as a convention, promising anybody who buys a ticket a hands-on, shrunk-down version of the industry.
No. Wukong!
That promise translates to spending an hour in line to play a few minutes of a game that'll be out in 6 months. It'll probably be sold back to GameStop.
Get back here, Wukong.
6.5 months.
Wukong.
That's
Wukong, you think you can fight me? Get back here, Wukong.
So, yeah, that's a good one.
Wukong!
It reinforces most bad stereotypes about games and gaming. The concept of gaming as a lifestyle may be the downfall of the games. It prioritizes the trappings of being into games and so-called gamer culture over actual games themselves. Most people at PAX probably live full, productive, satisfying lives. Dipping into the echo chamber of PAX inevitably suspends that for an entire weekend, reducing us to single-minded obsessives, the stereotypes that advertisers and marketers pay
try to turn us into that we normally refute daily. They tell us to wear game shirts, listen to game music, and ink, and eat and drink from gas stations and fast food drive-thrus. And during PAX, we do. I don't like this. This guy has shit reasons.
Dude, were you watching my stream? Or that? That long ass Wukong chase.
I have it up on my thing monitor.
I had such a long. I was just chasing Wukong for such a long time. So I finally, you know, got someone to kill him. I don't know why nerd turned early.
This is like the counter argument, I guess. Yeah, this is posted. The same day, by the same person. Says, it's the largest fan festival for games and we shouldn't have to abandon that space just because Penny Arcade and its fans are disrespectful. Oh my god.
I think this dude has something against Penny Arcade.
You play lots of board games. The best part of tech is the board game areas. And it's not because it's usually quieter. Even when they're stressful board games, they're still more relaxing. I think this guy hates video games. It's a good chance to play indie games you maybe wouldn't otherwise hear about. I first played Bastion, Skulls of the Shogun, and other great games at PAX East. So it's good for indie games. You can buy hard-to-find stuff. So you can buy stuff.
Oh, yeah, we can finish here. I didn't even realize.
Tyler can't go last. I think we may have to hold off until next year, sadly.
Yeah.
Maybe we should find something else to do instead. Because this is like sort of replacing our spring break, you know?
Yeah.
A lot of people go with their friends on vacation to like Mexico in spring break. But we're doing something else. Which is probably cheaper.
Alright.
And more interesting. More safe, too.
Unless Jacob Wisniewski and Marco all of a sudden come out and say they can go, I don't think we should go.
I think I agree. But we should do something else. Why can't Tyler go?
He doesn't graduate until the 20th of March, so.
The theory.
And what does he do then?
He just goes on base and can just lives military life from there on out.
For how long?
I think he went for 4 years? I don't know.
I think it's 4.
But he gets like vacations and stuff, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like a job.
I mean, he's not getting deployed. He's just being employed by the military.
But he could get deployed.
It was a very severe scenario.
Yeah.
He's like one of the last people they would deploy.
Yep.
Right. That's why people in like the Korean War and all that stuff, Vietnam, signed up for the army. I mean, signed up for the military. Because they knew that if they signed up, they probably wouldn't get deployed.
My grandpa signed up during the Korean War and he got deployed to Germany.
Nice. I didn't really think about what the Korean War was, really, until recently. And
it's
realized
the war that like every American wants to just forget about.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
You're going to want to move Piglet on your Piglet and Run. Alright, no. Piglet. Oh, wait, what the hell? But you do need to move Piglet off your roster for week one for your fantasy team. Because Piglet's not going to be in NA.
Why?
Visa problems. He should be next week, though. I think they said they got the visa like today, but.
I don't have another ADC though.
You did the add/drop thing.
What?
Oh, I just realized the type position you're in. Because you have both Mr. Rawls and Piglet, you have two ADs, and you can't have any more than two of a position. That's awkward. I think it's an art game. Stones, I bring
you
an
ancient power. You gotta think big.
I have, yeah. Will it just automatically use my flex ADC if I don't have an AD?
No, because your flex is an additional player.
No.
You're fucked with points.
You pretty much have to swap out Piglet and hope no one steals him away.
When does he... Wait, what? Oh, wait, so he'll be back, though, eventually, right?
Yeah, he'll be back next... He should be back next week.
I'll just leave him. He'll probably still do well. He's Piglet.
Well, yeah, if Kristik doesn't realize he needs to swap out the friggin' Rush and Impact...
Yeah, don't tell him. We need to decide something new to do now. I was looking forward to a journey.
Yeah.
Now we don't have a journey. We should pick another weekend.
Just to get placed in plat 3.
I mean, what else is there to do?
Go to Boston.
Starbone's is already back in Diamond. Wait, really?
But the week after PAX, how's that?
Wait, what?
What would that accomplish?
We'd be able to experience it. Add to the experience.
Road trip.
Creature road trip.
Just go. Oh, yeah, that's what we should do. We should go on the creature road trip.
I mean... Stuff. What's the actual week of spring break?
Oh,
I don't have that week off, but... It's, March.
You know, that April? Week.
I don't know what month it's in. But I just know that my spring break for high school is the week after the spring break for college.
That's right.
Yeah. But it's kind of cool because it means I don't get to go anywhere.
You don't like, get a full.
I don't get to do anything fun. That's fun.
Yes, it is.
That's all. I forgot. I need to tell my mom that. Hold on.
I mean, is there any smaller conventions going on around that time?
Gaming convention. Well, what weekend?
The weekend of spring break.
What do I need to know these days?
I don't know.
What?
Michigan High School.
They're all
spring break.
WLC spring break.
I'm super disappointed.
Central's calendar on their website is broke as hell. Can't look it up there.
Jacob. Your game is broken.
How so?
I'm searching for you on LoLskill.
Oh.
And it says you're still in the last game.
Yeah.
That's a good sign. Also, apparently you have a 53% chance to win that game.
Good.
So...
Yeah.
Not your current game. Your last game.
Yeah.
You got a good shot at winning it. I think you could do it.
Okay, April 3rd through the 10th, or 12th, I guess, actually, if you count the weekend. So, April 3rd through the 12th is spring break. I found it on Western.
Whoa, Timbers gets a shield now, too?
Yeah, that's what they're trying out, at least.
That's dumb. And he's kind of already strong. Go on, you piece of shit. Update.
Mm.
Alright, what name? What is one of your teammates' names that I can search instead?
Gavlin.
Yeah, you just... Here you go, I'll hold tab for you.
No, Jabby.
Really? That was cute.
Oh, smashed.
The only reason you're at a huge disadvantage is because one of the people in this game is actually ranked. So her skill score is about 4 times higher than the rest of yours, just because she has a rank. Looks like this person, that Irelia player, only plays Irelia. Because she has 4 ranked wins and 4 wins on Irelia.
Yeah.
5 losses, though. Don't know how she's ranked. Must have done pretty poorly in her placements. Let's see. Oh yeah, she played Kassadin once and lost.
You are nothing more than glass.
This doesn't make sense at all. Loss, 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 win, win, loss, 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 loss. Wow. She's really bad. The only games she's ever won this season are on Irelia, but she has played many more than the ones that she's played on Irelia. Tark's goddamn Dorito feet, man.
I know. Beautiful.
Why? Why was Riot so bad at making feet?
Because feet are hard.
Yeah, that's what Nami says. That's a Nami quote.
Are they? Or is it?
She says something like legs are weird or something.
Yeah, something like that.
Opal.
For vigor. Oh, I figured out something today. You know how it's annoying when you're playing support and then the ADC won't let you get Targan stacks done?
Yeah.
It's even more annoying when you're playing ADC and you try to give your support target stacks and then they miss it.
Yep.
And I'm like...
And that's why I don't blame people for not always letting them get it.
Yeah. It hurts so much when you're like, oh yeah, take this cannon. And then you see your Thresh walk up to it and he just doesn't even auto-attack. And
yeah.
I'm like, you just gave me cancer. My usual policy is I'll give you two chances.
Oh yeah. Speaking of cancer, we explained to Mr. Morgan what cancer is in Cisco.
Wait, what?
What actual cancer is? Or the internet term?
Internet term.
Oh. How so? How did that pan out? Can you please give me a play-by-play? I'm intrigued.
All right. So, Alex Red decided to play Sanic Ball in the middle fights.
Yeah, I love that game.
And
it's
Hunter
really...
something, I don't know his last name, asked, what the hell is this cancer? Mr. Morgan was like, huh?
He didn't respond to hell?
Oh no, it's all seniors. So
yeah, it's not really a bad word either, to be honest.
Yeah.
That Winston. And so what did Morgan think?
He kinda looked disappointed.
Oh.
I honestly don't think the principal being a teacher has made any of the kids behave any differently.
Nope.
I don't see why it would.
I'd see why it would, but I see why it would. But no one would really care.
More power.
Yeah, Morgan's just one of the chiller dudes.
Whoa,
he's like one of the most chill staff.
Like, what can Morgan do that a teacher can't?
Stuff.
Dude, I think Wazinski is like the coolest guy. Cause he's actually funny. It's weird. But you don't ever see him.
Is he the guy with like long hair sort of? Or is he the bald guy?
Wazinski is the short bald dude.
Oh.
Tall, bald, young dude. Not even bald. Tall one's Frey. Tall, young one.
Yeah.
I don't. I never see these people, so. I don't know.
Well, you only go to school for 2 hours a day.
So. Yeah. And if you screw up in 2 hours, you've got a problem.
I've only had to actually go to Frey once, and that was actually with Jacob.
Yeah, that was that stupid time.
What happened?
We got Marcus.
Marked us absent.
Yeah.
Wait, what?
We got marked absent in a class, and like a couple days later, he's like, "So why were you two unexcused absent?"
And we were just like.
Like, what are you talking about?
Like, he calls you down if you have an unexcused absence?
Not typically.
I've never had one.
So that's why I'm confused about it. That's why you're so confused, like, why are you calling this?
But I did have the problem where... Oh, sorry, Kenny, go ahead.
But yeah, Nick and I were just wondering what the hell, like, we're like, so what did we do exactly when we were walking down there? Because we're just talking about, like, we're like, I'm like, hey, Nick, you do anything wrong? Nope. Hey, Jake, you do anything wrong? No.
Sapphire or divinity. The only problem I've ever had with, like, having to go somewhere was, like, actually a couple days ago when it was last Wednesday. So strange. Just why? I don't understand. Last Wednesday, finals, right? I do not have classes on Wednesday. So I was like, oh boom, great idea, I'll come in while everyone else is doing finals. And I'll make up my tests. And Mrs. Borkist was fine with it. So I was like, cool. So I went in and I made up my beloved test and my Death of the Salesman test and my beloved quiz.
So the burst damage between Ezreal and Tariq is stupid.
Oh, yeah. So I came in.
Run.
I made them up, and then I was like, oh, okay, I'm gonna leave, because it was, you know, halfway through one of the classes, through one of the finals classes, so I figured I would leave a little faster. I mean, I left when I was done, but I was, like, happy because it was, like, in between, it was during one of the classes, so I wouldn't have to, like, fight my way out of the parking lot, you know?
So, yeah.
I was walking out and this lady ran up to me and was like, hey there, young man, where are you?
Oh, I know, yeah, the tall miner.
And I'm like, I'm leaving, I'm going home. And she was like, oh, okay, come with me for a little bit. And I'm like, okay, but I have to leave soon. And she was like, oh, don't worry, we won't be long.
Oh, she took you to Frey because she thought you were skipping or something.
Yeah, and I was like, and so it got really awkward from there.
I could tell.
Not only that, the first I had to explain to her that A, I did not actually, I was allowed to leave. Then she was like, okay, just sign out and, you know, you can go ahead and leave. And I'm like, well, the problem is, I'm not actually signed in, because I don't have any classes right now. And she's like, I think that just like broke a fuse in her head, because she totally derped out after that, and did not understand anything. So I had to go to the front desk.
Dude, she's not the brightest.
I had to go to the front desk and be like, hey, I don't have a class right now, I was making up some tests, can I go? And she was like, yeah. So I just left.
Yeah, the freaking dust ladies don't care about anything. They're like, yeah, I'm here, I don't want to be here.
So, I don't know, I was kind of curious about what would happen if I did sign out. Because I think it would break their system.
Probably.
It's like, okay, this guy, he
left, and he's not supposed to be here. But he's saying he's leaving. I'm confused. Breaking.
It's like I stayed the night there. never went home the night before.
Yeah. They told the Hellminers to go into full Hitler mode. And it's funny because I saw a couple people get caught. Like they were actually.
I don't know.
Around the halls.
I've never skipped class. It seems like it'd be kind of hard to do. And even, honestly, paradoxically enough, harder to mess up. Like, if you're gonna skip class, why would you walk around the school? That's what I don't get. If I'm skipping class, I'm fucking bolting.
It's actually really easy to skip class by leaving school, because when you get back, people pretty much always open the door for you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I ran into that problem that same day, because I wore a really light jacket, because I was like, I'm going to be walking from the car to the school, that's it. Then I got up to the door, and it was locked, and there was no one there. So I had to walk.
Oh yeah, I remember you talking about this before.
Yeah, and I'm like, oh my god.
But as for people skipping in school,
that
there's literally always a group of at least 10 Chaldeans that skip right outside D100 every day, fifth hour.
Yep. Really? I know at exactly who you're talking about.
What? I just don't understand. What's their goal? Why would they skip?
To be Chaldean.
If not being class
in school, you might as well get credit for it.
Yeah, that's.
You think? You
being in E2020, I realize that not all people are concerned about passing their classes.
Yeah.
About 90% of people there are there because they failed at least like 5 classes.
Damage. No, it was the Ezreal, Tarik and Jace combo.
Oh boy. I've realized Assassin Metal is OP, but possibly more OP is Full Poke. That is really, really annoying with the way Dragon and Baron works right now.
Yep.
Because if you have a Nidalee and a Jace, and then you get Baron, and you walk up to a tower, you're all slamming the people, and your cannons are slamming the tower.
This boss is too easy. I kill him in 3 hits. This is why high level Borderlands is cool. Cause you get rewards. if you have perfect gear.
You know what? I hate Islam.
Why?
Let's just move on to that discussion. Islam, the religion?
Yeah.
I don't like it.
Why?
Why? What is there to like about it, first of all?
You get to see a lot of sand.
There are Muslims in America and stuff.
Yeah, but they're oppressed.
Oppressed?
Oppressed.
By who?
Racial profiling. Never heard that. It's called, 9/11.
I don't think that's oppression. I think that that's, the other word that starts with a P.
Paradox.
Nope.
Penis. that's true.
Persecution. That's this one.
Personify.
My dog does this really weird thing where if you, like, rub him in a certain spot, he, like, thumps his leg really hard and his entire body shakes uncontrolled.
Welcome to dogs.
What's up with that?
I don't know. I just really like it.
It's right, like, on his inner legs. He's been sitting here for, like, 30 minutes.
And hasn't ripped your face off yet?
Why would he? He's a nice dog.
You don't know that.
Everyone knows that dogs are vicious creatures.
Everyone knows that Muslims are vicious creatures. I'm just sandstorm. Waiting. What?
Dirt sandstorm.
What the? I'm just waiting for someone in the class to bring up religion so I can smite them.
Just be all like, yo, religion's stupid.
Yeah. And I think Candide is a perfect opportunity for that. Because Voltaire makes fun of religion.
Cool.
Like, the first time he meets the Christians, they're like, you hate the Pope? And he's like, I don't know, I've never met him. And they're like, fuck you! And they kick him out. Which is sort of Voltaire's parody of Christians helping people, but only if they like them. Or more specifically, don't not like them.
Okay.
This rocket lawn chair. Oh. Lawn chair. Yeah. Ouch. Sapphire for divinity. Oh, almost dead. No, just let me hit you.
Opal for harmony.
emerald for insight. Opal for harmony.
Jeez.
Opal for harmony. Emerald for insight.
Thank you.
for harmony.
Niantic, nice.
Ruby for vigor.
I want to build some orange. This.
With clarity. Ruby for vigor. Sapphire or divinity.
Thornmail by Antaric. Just hilarious.
You're saying with infinite armor mode activated?
Yeah. That is. Eh. and I was just like, I was able to fight their whole team just like between one null magic mantle, ninja tabby, thorn mail, and face of the mountain. Like, I was able to tank their whole team for such a long time by spamming my heal and just leaving my W up.
Cool.
It's also useful to use my ult because it gives me extra AP. Yeah, I survived pretty much. Like, I pretty much was able to half health the Irelia who was autoing me the entire time because of Thorn Mail. Yeah, we have an AD team.
Emerald for insight.
All these inhibs then, just all the super minions we get this would just make minions too OP. Giant Tarik is beautiful.
Wow, I've made a lot of money doing this.
That was a good game. Alright.